My past is a town of crumbling ruins. Laid in the valley, open to wind and rain. My future a city bright and golden. Safe on the heights of Jesus' royal
It was 1996 and I was coming through Mumbai, sitting in the rickshaw, and a whole bunch of kids came asking for food or money. And out of them, one little girl around 6 years old really got my attention. She was very malnourished and kind of really, really hopeless look on her eyes. And I didn't know what to do. I didn't speak the language. So I took whatever change I had in my pocket and just gave it to her. Signal turned green and the rickshaw got moving. Out of curiosity, I just looked back and I saw an older girl coming and snatching this money from her. Very angry, frustrated, and felt very helpless, didn't know what to do. Went back to my hotel room and kind of asked God, God, why do you allow this to happen? If you are there and if you are powerful and almighty, why do these kids have to go through such suffering and hopelessness? I really felt God asking me, why don't you do something about it? That's where it all started, and that day changed my life. That six-year-old girl, who I never met again, I don't know her name, she changed my life.
This is 10 years back, like when I met Pastor Biju. He just shared his heart for the children who are living on the streets. And that time I told him, like, we will go to one of the location where there is a lot of street children.
And we went to Mine Station, bought some vada pav, and sat on the platform and started feeding about six children.
And we told them, like, we are going to come back again tomorrow. And that way we kept going every day. And end of the month, we were having nearly 40 children.
So it was in 2006 that we got our first educational bus. So these children, they either do not go to school or they drop out at a very early age because of two reasons. One is they are not interested in education. And the second one, they are not confident they can make anything good out of their life. So what we do is we bring non-formal education to them, where we get them inside the bus, And when we teach them a few different subjects, out of which we want every one of these children to say, yes, I want to study, and yes, I can study.
In 2008, the first daycare center was also started right in the middle of the red light district of Mumbai. These kids were living in a high-risk environment where they were exposed and vulnerable to sexual abuse and trafficking.
Actually, a lot happened between 2009 and 2011. We introduced two more educational buses. We were able to have them and get them out on the road, impacting a lot more children. At the same time, we started our mobile medical and mobile dental units during those times.
We have a van, and this van goes to different locations where the drug addicts are there. And in this van, like, most of the drug addicts come inside where we do the counseling. We help them come out of this drug addiction